We just need to get things organized. We need to know what everybody's doing and, you know, everybody's part in the ministry and all that kind of good stuff.
Amen.
I'm hoping and praying that we can get Freedom's on the line tonight as well, seeing as though he is the assistant. Amen. He is second in command to me. Amen. And if anything should happen, God forbid, if anything should happen to me, he would step up as the presiding prelate of Powerhouse Ministries International. And we're going to establish each and every one. For instance, Minister Robin Lynn.
I'm here.
Amen. Got her set up as the international liaison for the ministry because she's dealing with Pakistan. She's going to be dealing with Monrovia, Liberia, dealing with all of the ministers in these other countries, amen, that we've taken under our umbrella. Amen. Want to welcome the caller that just came in, area code 253.
That's me, Minister Robin Lynn.
Oh, okay. You got two phones.
Yeah, I'm broadcasting through the other one. So.
Okay. Bless God. Amen.
Literally wired for sound right now.
well, bless his holy name. Amen. We're going to at the appropriate hour, well, it's coming up on us right now. So I'm going to turn the recording on so that we can, you know, each and every last one of us are going to get a copy.
This conference is being recorded.
We're going to get a copy of this recording tonight. I'm going to send it out to everybody so that we'll be able to go back over and, you know, everybody will know exactly what it is that we're supposed to be doing. But as I was stating before, this is what Minister Robin Lynn is doing. She's also been taking care of media for the ministry. She's been taking care of that. Mike Bradford at a point was doing that himself, amen, pushing the media forward. He's been out for a while, and I know that he can't do anything for a minute, so Minister Robin Lynn has taken on that as well. But you guys know that Mike Bradford, a man, is doing quite well now. We thank God, amen, that he's shaken back, that God has, amen, blessed him. And he got his PayPal account fixed. Because we were kind of concerned about the way things jumped off just recently with a brother. If I could just be candid with everybody, Mike Parker came on the broadcast, and and I've listened to the message. He had told us that Mike Bradford was stating that at 5 o'clock p.m. all of the websites were going to go directly to him or whatever the case may be, and it wasn't quite that way. So, amen, glory be to God, we've straightened that mess out. So if anyone wishes to contribute to Evangelist Mike Bradford to help him, amen, because, again, he is not working. You know, the hospital bills have stacked up in different things of this nature. I'm sowing into him, and I want others, amen, if you are able, amen, to sow into his ministry. His PayPal account is under revivalfire@cableone.net. Amen. If you go, if you have a PayPal account, you can go in and, you know, you just put the person's email in there and boom, you can send it directly to him. That goes directly to him. That goes directly to him. It does not go through a middleman no more. It goes directly through him. Okay, so that's revivalfire@cableone.net. Amen. Glory be to God. We want to, amen, remember that. Also, For those of you who are aware or not aware, you know, Prophet Williams wrote his book, Abuse to Recovery. And it's out on the market right now, and I want to share with you also the website for that. This is what we're going to be doing for each other, incidentally. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. I'm just about to finish up with my book. It's fascinating because the more I write, the more comes out of me. And mm-hmm. I had no idea some of the things that I had tucked away or buried in my mind, so many things that I've been through, and I'm not hiding anything. You know, it's a blessing that he said that, you know, he was inspired to write his book because of me. Amen. Glory be to God. It touched me. It touched me a lot because, you know, as I was sharing with him, I'm not holding nothing back. I want people to know what the Lord has delivered me from. I want people to understand why I am the way I am, why I don't play with the devil. I don't play with him at all. I got no talk for him. I got no play. I got no love for him whatsoever. When you sit back and really take a look at what he's put us through in our lives, amen, there should be nothing but hatred for him. I'm talking about hatred. And yeah, I hate him. Amen. I know folks will sit up and say that's a strong word. You're not supposed to have. The devil is a lie. I hate him. I hate what he stands for. I hate what he's doing. I hate what he's trying to do with my children. I hate what he's trying to do with other people's children. I hate what he's doing with marriages. I hate what he's doing with sickness and disease in people's bodies. I hate him. You hear what I say? I hate him. And come if on. We don't hate sin, if we don't hate the devil, amen, glory be to God, I'm telling you right now, something wrong. Something wrong. Because I can't stand him. I'm just going to be honest with you. But that website, amen, for his book is www.createspace.com/423-4135. We're going to be posting that up on all of our networks, Facebook, and everywhere else. We can. I'm going to put it on my studio, put it up on the studio and link it so that people can get that book. I'm truly, truly thankful, amen, for everyone being here. We want to welcome, amen, area code 202 on the line there, amen. Glory be to God. Thank you for being here with us on tonight. Amen. Glory be to God. We want to open up in prayer just right quick, and then we're going to go ahead and get into this meeting. Minister Robin.
Yes.
Minister, did you get in touch with Apostle Reed?
Yes, I sure did. She said she remembered. I think she'll be here.
Right. I'm here.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Lord, sneaking in here on me like that there.
I'm here.
Hell.
Oh, Lord, that person, I didn't recognize the number, but I tell you, I'm glad you're here. Amen.
Amen. Right, God bless you.
Amen. God bless you. Let's open up in a word of prayer, everybody. Father, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you, Lord God, for this day that you've made. We honor you, Lord God, for all of your bountiful blessing. We thank you, Lord God, for this nucleus, these your people. Come together, Lord God, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, for no other purpose than to help move the ministry forward, Lord God, to win more souls, to come up with ideas, Lord God, so that we can push the gospel forward. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you would be in the midst of us, Lord God, and that you would give us, Lord God, your will. Let us know what you want in the precious name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. And I pray you, Lord God, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, that you would keep us humble. Lord God, keep us in the center of your will in the precious name of Jesus Christ. We praise you. We thank you. We honor you, Lord God, in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Bless these your children tonight in the precious name of Jesus Christ. We glorify you and we thank you for this right now. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Glory to God and amen. All right. Praise God. Now I'm keeping a minute over here, as they call it in the church. I'm keeping minutes Let's see, we got myself, Tamiko Timberlake in here, Jamie Lim is in here, Minister Robin Lynn, Apostle Geraldine Green Reed, Evangelist Mike Bradford. Did I miss anybody? Let me see. I got everybody, right? Yeah, I got everybody. Okay. All right. Praise God. So, the purpose for this meeting, as I stated, is for us to come up with some ideas so that we can move this thing forward. Now, the first thing, I said this before with another group of people, but I'm going to say this again. Apostle Green Reed is selling clothes. So we want to try to help her market what she's doing so that she can be blessed financially, so that she can do what God has called her to do. Amen. I'm writing a book. You follow what I'm saying? So we want to try to help put it out there. Once I get it taken care of, we want to put it out there on your networks to help so that we, you follow what I'm saying? Same thing with Minister Robin Lynn and Evangelist Mike Bradford and anybody else that has something going on. We want to help each other get it out there. You know what I'm saying? And we want to push it. We want to push it. We want to encourage people. Look, go on over here and check this out. She's got, let me tell you something. I've seen some wonderful looking clothes. You hear me? And I think you got a daughter out there doing the same thing, Apostle Reed. I saw an outfit, man, the dress, the shoes, the purse. I was like, whoa. Yeah. It was nice. So we wanna do that for each other. We wanna help market what the other is doing so that, when one person prospers, we all prosper. That's when one is blessed, we're all blessed. That's you follow what I'm saying?
That's right. That is the truth.
We're all part of the household of faith, and we want to be able to be a blessing. Now, I don't know about anybody else, but it's frustrating to hear about what's needed, you know, not only just in other countries, but right here with our own brothers and sisters, and my hands are tied, and I can't do anything about it. It's frustrating. It's very frustrating. But if we come together as Christ would have us to do, And like, for instance, if you got something going on, Apostle Reed, you got some clothes that need to go out or whatever the case may be, praise the Lord. I see Bishop and Evangelist Scott in the house. Amen. If you got something going on, then you need to let us know so that we can jump on it. Now, I don't know if we're all connected in the different places. I'm on LinkedIn, I'm on Google+, I'm on Lord have mercy, everybody know about Facebook, Twitter, and MySpace. I'm over there as well. And believe it or not, there are some people over there that actually follow the ministry. So, you know, people talk about MySpace like a dog, but eventually Facebook gonna wind up the same way. You know what I'm saying? They all gonna phase out after a while because it's just getting old. But my point is that we need to utilize what we have to help each other.
Right. Exactly.
Do what God has called us to do. You know, some people have they make a livelihood from selling clothing or whatever the case may be, whatever the situation is. You may have an event going on in your church or whatever the case may be. We want to help put that out there. I can take what you're doing, put it on all of my networks so that, you know, all of the people that are following me, amen, will know exactly what's going on, all those people that are in that city or in that community or whatever the case may be, but they can get on over that. They can get on over that. This is one of the things that we want to do. Now, I mentioned this before to a lot of other people, and it's fascinating because apparently they had it in their mind that they simply want to move themselves forward. This is something that's bothering me about the body. We're more concerned about building self and pushing self forward, which is that narcissistic spirit.
Yeah.
You follow what I'm saying? That's narcissism. Yeah. That's that me, my, and I syndrome. Mm-hmm. I can't stand that because Jesus is not about me, my, and I. He's about the will of his Father, and he's about loving everybody. Everybody, desiring for everybody to be set free, not just certain people, not just people that I care about, but everybody. I want everybody to be set free. This is the attitude, and as we shared even on yesterday, out of Ephesians, every last one of us is supposed to be striving to be like Jesus. I'm not trying to be like damn man down here on the face of this planet. I don't know if anybody got a chance to look at T.D. Jakes or look at, what's that woman's name, The Battlefield of the Mind, Joyce Meyer. I sat up and listened to them folk talk today, and I was like, God, they're dead. I don't sense no Holy Ghost nowhere. Nowhere. I'm sitting back like, what happened, Lord? What happened? T.D. Jakes, there was a time when that man would speak, I'd get goosebumps all over my body. Now, he's just making a noise. What happened? What the devil? I'll tell you what happened. We done got this superstar mentality. We done popped up out of the will of God because of all of these people patting us on the back and everything. We done lost sight of our true purpose. We done lost sight. The narcissism in the house of the Lord. That spirit is running rampant. It's about me. It's about me. It's my time. I see people posting up on Facebook all the time. It's my time. It's about me. What?
Mm-hmm.
It ain't never been about us.
Come on.
It ain't never been about us. It's always been about Jesus. And that is what we need to be promoting. We need to promote Jesus. We need to get him out there. We need to get him out there. There's a reason why we're preaching the way we are. And I'm going to tell you something. I believe with all of my heart. I believe with all of my heart that God, he's going to frustrate a lot of folk after a while. He's going to frustrate a lot of people because, see, we're highly esteeming man, and we ain't giving no glory to God whatsoever.
Yeah.
It ain't cool. That's not cool. So I'm not said man. It's about Jesus today. It's about him.
Right.
So this is what we want to do. We want to start helping each other move forward. Because even as I was in financial service, I learned this a long time ago. And John Maxwell and so many others. I've in financial services, I met multimillionaires, and I knew one billionaire in my lifetime. And I'm telling you, each and every last one of them told me the same thing. If you want to be prosperous, if you want to be blessed, help somebody else achieve their goals. Help somebody else achieve their dream, and it will bless you. It'll turn around and bless you. And I have found that to be so. It will come back. You help somebody else get where they're trying to go. So this is what we want to do. I don't know, like I said, I don't know if everybody's connected with each other with these different social networks or whatever the case may be, but we need to let each other know what we're doing so that we can help promote the other. You follow what I'm saying? Help promote. Your livelihood is in selling those clothes, Apostle Reed, so we want to try to help get that moving forward. You follow what I'm saying? And the same thing with everybody else, all of us working together as a nucleus to push what God has got us doing forward. So that's one of the things that I wanted to get across to everybody. Like, for instance, Rob and Lucinda Boyd from The Streets Don't Love You Back, everything they post, I'll share it. I'll repost it on my walls so that everybody on my list can see what they're doing. And I do that pretty much everywhere. I want to be able to help them move their ministry forward. They're doing a good work for the Lord. I want to be able to do that. So this is what I'm going to start doing. I'm going to start reposting. I'm going to start sharing what other people are doing to help expose them, to help expose their ministry. So we started out like that, even over there on Blog Talk. You remember We would call different ministers in and have them come and minister because our purpose was to expose other ministries. You know what I'm saying? I wanted people to know we're not the only ones out there preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're not the only ones out there anointed. I mean, there's tons of us out here. I wanted folks to know, amen, glory be to God. God is using whomsoever he pleases. So this is the mentality that I have today. It's the same mentality. I want people to know what you're doing. And you in turn can help me, and we can get the word out, glory be to God. Like, for instance, Minister Robin Lynn, she takes all of the messages and she posts them up here, there, and everywhere. Good God Almighty, and that's my purpose, is to get the word out. I don't care about anything else. I just want to get the word out. I want people to be blessed by God's word, period. That's my purpose. That's what I'm doing this for. So she's helping Evangelist Mike Bradford doing the same thing. He put it out there. He posted up. Hey, he put it up on his Facebook wall. You guys need to hear this man of God, blah, 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 blah. Put it out there. You follow what I'm saying? This is what we need to do for one another. This is what we need to do for one another. We want to help each other move forward. And I'm telling you, when people see the oneness, when they see that this part of the body of Christ is with one accord, you can't help but win. You can't help but succeed. That's the point. That's the point even that Jesus was trying to make. You know what I'm saying? He wanted us to be one with one another as he is one with his Father. He wants all of us to help each other. We're helpless one to another, as the Bible says. So this is one of the reasons, one of the things that I wanted to discuss. So, Apostle Reed, starting with you, do you have a website dedicated to the clothing line?
Okay. First of all, good evening to everyone. I'm so blessed and just grateful to be here this evening. The clothing line is called the Song of Solomon. God named it the Song of Solomon Affordable Boutique. Now, right now, the web designer, she's still working on the website. I overloaded her with clothing, and she's still trying to get everything situated. So we were hoping to have gotten the website up last weekend, but now I'm hoping that at least by the end of this week we'll be able to have the website up. And we have a PayPal account on the website, et cetera. We will be able to ship clothes wherever you are within the USA, not outside of the USA, but within the USA. We will be able to ship the clothing to you, we'll have it shipped to you, that type of thing. And, you know, my thing is that, as Apostle just said, we're here, we should be here to help one another, because everyone that is on this line has a Facebook account. So if you have a Facebook account and you go and you put the Song of Solomon Affordable Boutique information up there, and you put Prophet Williams' information about his book and Apostle's information about his book, then everybody on your that's in your connection, all of your connections will see that information. And then those same connections can connect with other connections. And that's the way we get started. So, you know, that is, it's, you know, to me, it's imperative that we start doing that. That was one of the things that I said yesterday when we were on the on the call with Prophet Williams. You know, we've got to stop acting like crabs in a barrel. We've got to be willing to help each other, because it's not about you to start with. And you just don't know who's going to be blessed by the information that's being put out. You know, I had a young lady that came to me the other day, and she's in the 12th grade. She's getting ready for a prom. And she came to me and she said, "Dr. Reed, you know, I got my dress, but I don't have my prom shoes." And I said, "Okay." I said, "What are you looking for?" She told me what she's looking for. So I found her the shoes that she wants. And she came back to me today, and she said, I've got some customers for you. Well, what I had told her, because God had laid it on my heart, he said, you let her know that if she brings you some customers, you will buy her prom shoes for her.
Hallelujah.
And I told her, I said, you know, I'll get your prom shoes. They'll be here by the end of this week. And she was like, are you serious? And I was like, didn't you bring me some customers? And she said, yes, ma'am, I bought you two. I said, it doesn't matter if you bought me one or two. I said, you did what I asked you to do, so it's okay. I got you. And she was like, oh, my God, nobody's ever done this for me. And I was like, well, I got you. I got you. I've already got you. I know what size you wear, know what you want, you know, that kind of thing. So with these clothes, I am telling people that, you know, I will be more than happy to give you free clothing, whatever. All I'm asking is that you support what God has put in place. Support the vision that God has given to me, because this vision was given to me many, many years ago.
Amazing.
I didn't step out on faith because I was afraid to try to do it by myself. God brought it back to me 4 years ago. I started with it with my daughter-in-law, but then my daughter-in-law dropped it in my lap, and I, again, you know, got sidetracked, didn't do it. So God brought it back to me 6 months ago and said, okay, what are you waiting for? I keep asking you about the Song of Solomon Affordable Boutique. And I said, okay, God, I'm doing it. And I just immediately, you know, got on the website. The Lord showed me websites, and I called up a couple of vendors that I knew from years back. You know, hey, you're still in business. You still have clothing. They said, yeah, you know, you're back. And I was like, yeah, I'm back. And, you know, that was it. And, I mean, it's wonderful. The clothes are good quality clothes. They're not some little cheap fly-by-night clothes. They're good quality clothes. The shoes, the jewelry, the clothing, all of it. You know, ultimately, once the women's line is up and going, we'll be going into the men's line as well, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because I've seen some really tight men's suits that I want to get a hold of. So, you know, we're going to be going into that. So, you know, we just need to support one another. You know, that's
right.
What this is all about, supporting one another. Whatever you're trying to do, if it's you know, you're doing something, hey, just let me know what you're doing. I'll be glad to put it on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, whatever I got. You know, I'll be glad to, you know, send it to me and say, hey, Doc, would you mind putting this on whatever you got? You know, hey, done. And that's it.
It's not taking anything away from anybody.
No, not at all.
It's accentuating.
That's right.
It's actually causing people to know, okay, this person is selfless. They're not selfish. They're not out for number one. They're trying to help others as well. You know, it was fascinating to me. I'm listening to your testimony. Every last one of us have been in that situation. But now listen to me real good, because I'm talking to everybody on the line. There are those right now. I you know, God spoke to me even concerning the Scots. They could write a book, as a matter of fact, several books, about what they've been through, what her husband has been through. These are avenues. These are, because, you know, I've been crying out to God, Lord, bless our finances. And God is telling me, he said, I've given you the ability to make money. You just got to sit down and write it out. Everything that you've been through, let me tell you something, people pay big money to read about the things that you've been through, the obstacles that you've overcome, the things that have taken place in your life, and you're still here. You're still blessed. You're still lifting up the name of Jesus. What is it that's kept you this? You understand what the people, like my daughter, I'm on her. Write a book. You know what I'm saying? She's been out in them streets for years doing drugs and alcohol, selling her precious body. She was on the brink of death and so many others. I want her to write a book because people need to know that God is still moving, that God is still saving, that God is still delivering. You understand what I'm saying? People want to know. They want to know the truth. They want to know the truth. And these are ways for us to be able to obtain finances that we need to move our ministries forward, to take care of our homes, our families, different things.
Yeah.
He's given us the ability to do so. Now, if other people can write books, why can't we?
That's right.
If other people, if other people can get it out there, why can't we? If other people are being blessed by what they're putting out, how come we can't? I'm going to tell you something. Every last one of them started out the same way. They had a think tank group. They had what we used to call, We'd come together and we put some ideas out there, and we would, and once we come to an agreement on what we wanted to do, what we thought would be most successful or whatever the case may be, we would implement it. We would put it out there. This is the reason why I'm saying what I'm saying now, and I'm trying to encourage somebody right now, to take. Let me tell you, I heard it put this way: take your mess and make it your message. Take whatever you've been through and make it your mess. I'm telling you, we sit back and look at everybody else. Everybody else is doing this. Now, I made the suggestion before about us putting together a daily devotion, putting together making CDs that people can pop into their CD players in their cars and hear the word, you know what I'm saying, or hear a word of encouragement. How come we can't do that? How come we can't? Why is it everybody else can do it, but we can't? Come on here. Ain't no difference between us and them. I'm sorry. There is no difference. We have a word from the Lord, too. We have, amen, glory be to God, gifts, too. And just like the Bible says, the workman is worthy of his eye. Now, I'm telling you, amen, glory be to God, if we sow our spiritual things, there's nothing for us to reap their carnal things. Now, I'm just going to be real honest. We're always crying out to God for finances and different things of this nature, and God has given us the talents. He's given us the tools. We have computers. We have word processors. We have CD burners and everything else. Come on here, somebody, talk to me. How come we can't take the messages that we do on Blog Talk or on Spreaker or wherever the case may be, paste them on the doggone CDs, and then put them out there when we go visiting somebody or put it out on the web? These are available if you want this or that or whatever the case may be. I'm telling you, somebody will get it. As the old adage goes, if you build it, they'll come.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, there's somebody that will patronize you, buy your product, and not only that, put it out there for you. Now, I'm telling you, and in the process, they're being blessed and you're being blessed. Now, I'm saying this, and I said this, Scott, because that's who God put on my spirit when I was sitting there. You were talking, Apostle Reed, and I was sitting there, and God reminded me of my asking him to give the increase in my finances so that I could be a blessing, so that I could do the things that he's called me to do. And he reminded me of a book. And then automatically, Bishop Scott, mm-hmm. and Teresa Scott came to my mind. You guys should write about your lives, the things that you've been through. People could benefit. First of all, their eyes could be enlightened to an issue they know nothing about. And I'm telling you, books are being put out every day. Every day. Yeah. Now, we want God to move. Well, utilize the gifts that he's given to you. I was scared, Apostle Reed. I'm not going to lie. I was scared to step out by faith. I was scared. He told me, he said, I want you to step out and get a building. Do you know? And then, Lord, I was like, what? God, I ain't even got a job. How am I going to? You understand what I'm saying? See, the mind automatically went to, you know, what I can't do. You know what I'm saying? What I can't do. But God told me, he said, if I told you to go get it, then that means I got something for you.
That's right.
Come on here. And he said, if I told you to go get it, then that means I got something for you. Now you just go get it. And Lord, we got it. We went and got it, and everything flowed like it was supposed to. Everything just fell into place. Now my point is that fear are demons standing up with their hands on your chest trying to push you backwards to keep you from obtaining the blessing that God has for you. That critical spirit is always telling us that we're incapable of doing what it is that, write a book. Where do I begin? What do I say? Yes. Oh, 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 come on here. All I got to do is sit back and think about what I've been through. Oh, this is what I need to do. I need to come up with a table of contents. What do I want to say? What is my purpose? What do I want the people to walk away from this book knowing? What is it that I'm trying to do? Those are the questions that we need to ask. And once we have the answer, writing the book ain't nothing. It ain't nothing. What is my purpose? What do I want the people to know? What message am I trying to get across? It's just like writing out your sermon. Now, I don't know about the rest of y'all, but Apostle Timberlake don't retain information like he used to, so I write my stuff down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
See, I intend on doing a memoir, too. I also intend on taking the messages that I've preached, the lessons that I've taught, and put them in a book as well. You think people don't want that? People buy books all the time with sermon outlines and different things to this name. They sell like hotcakes.
You got hundreds of people listening to you every day now.
Yeah, and see, this is the point. This is the point. We've got to overcome our fear.
Yes.
We've got to overcome our fear. And we need to come away from this ideology that others are greater than us.
Jesus.
Come on here. Come on here. I'm serious now. We need to stop looking at folks like they're giants. And we're a little insignificant, whatever. The devil is a lie. The same God, amen, glory be to God, that is operating in them is operating in us.
Hey, come on.
The same God. You know what I say? He's operating in us, too. So we need to own. See, let me tell you something. One of the things that God, and this is the reason why I don't, I'm telling you right now, I don't fear no more. If he tell me to do something, I'm gone. I promise you for God, I don't fear no more. Why? Because I know that I know that I know whatever he tell me to do, he has already enabled me to do it. Do you think him telling me to open up a multi-purpose building, a treatment slash transitional living housing for people that come out of prison is a simple thing for me? We got to come up with money. I'm talking about money to get the building built, to buy the land, the whole nine yards, certain permits and different things that need to be done. You don't think the devil done put in my mind, oh, you ain't going to get all that, you this, that, and the other, and you ain't prepared, and you ain't got no money, you ain't got no backers or whatever. Well, let me tell you something. Everybody started someplace. Mm-hmm. Everybody. All I know is that Jesus said, watch this now, ask, and ye shall receive. He said, not. He said, not. Seek, and ye shall find. Then he said, knock, and it shall be opened unto you.
Come on.
The acronym is ask.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Seek, knock. Ask. He didn't say how many times. Oh, glory to Moshiach. Glory to God. Do you know the man that wrote the book? What is the name of that book? Somebody just told me about it last night. Minister Lynn.
A driven purpose life, Rick Warren, his son?
No. I'm talking, there's an individual that wrote, matter of fact, they just made a movie. Oh, it's called The Help. He wrote the book The Help, and he tried to get it published 60 times before somebody finally said yes. 60 times, do you hear me?
Yeah.
Edison tried, he failed 10,000 times before he finally got the doggone bulb working. And you know what he said? When the people asked him, what did he do? They said, how did you come up with it? He said, I finally did what I never did before. He finally tried something else other than what he had been doing all along. My point here is that we may get some no's. When I was in financial services, I got a bunch of no's. But I kept going through them no's until I started getting some yeses. You know what I'm saying? In the midst of that, you're going to get some yeses. God is going to bless you. Look at Tyler Perry. Tyler Perry went through hell. We're sleeping outdoors, for God's sake. Look at where he is now. because he persevered, because he refused to give up. You hear what I say? Every last one of us has been blessed by God. I'm telling you what I know. I'm not telling you what I feel. I'm telling you what I know. Every last one of us has been blessed by God, has been given talent, has been given, amen, the means, amen, and the way, amen, to receive finances to help move the ministry forward, to help move your lives forward, to live a better life. He has given each and every last one of us that ability. Every last one of us. I'll be doggone. I'm not wasting it no longer. I'm not wasting it no longer. All it takes is a little effort on our part. That's all it takes. Yes.
Oh, you can hear me?
Yes.
Good evening. This is Evangelist Teresa.
Yes.
I just wanted to say that I know it was God that led me to message you earlier, but
yes.
I didn't know it was going to turn into this. However, everything that you're saying is confirmation because the Lord has really been dealing with me about writing this book.
Isn't that something?
And I actually started writing on the one that I'm already writing. I already started writing on it again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Fear, mm-hmm. I can say that for a fact, that fear has been a major part of me not completing it, fear of what people might say. Fear of rejection.
Yes.
You know, and I've written for many years. I already published a book and was part of another person's book. And then, you know, it's just fear.
Mm-hmm.
But when I was coming in the room, the Lord spoke the same thing that you said. He said, I've already given you a way.
Wow.
But you just won't do it.
My God, come on now. Come on.
I walked in the room. I promise you, you weren't on the phone.
Nope.
I walked in my room, and that's just what the Holy Spirit said to me like that. And when you were saying it on the phone, I was like, oh, my gosh. it was really crazy, but, you know, I had heard it in my spirit. The Lord was like, don't do anything until you finish this book. So I have to be diligent and finish it because one of them I'm almost finished, but you know, the story about my husband and myself, what we've been through, I don't even know where to begin. But I was actually talking to my oldest son the other night about it, and he was like, Mom, stop thinking about what people are going to think about you and write
that's
the book.
Right.
Like,
that's
he really
right.
got upset with me.
Yes.
He was like, will you just go ahead and write the book? So, and I, you know, every time I try to take these jobs, I get sick because that's not what God want me to do.
Nope.
So
I've been through the same thing. I cannot hold down a secular job. I can't do it. Can't do it.
Yeah, my husband,
you know,
he said, Teresa, that's not, you keep trying to do that, but that's not what God wants you to do. You got to have faith and
that's
just
right.
do what God told you to do, and he's going to provide.
That's it. That's
so,
it.
So, you know, all of this is just confirmation. That's what I wanted to say.
Jesus,
as far as us promoting one another, you know, we're having a women's conference in June.
Yeah.
I know I spoke to you about this before, and we're looking for God to, you know, to heal some people. Just healing from being abused, and you know, because that was my life, and I know that if God can heal me, He'll heal them too.
That's right. That's right.
So this is why this conference is happening, and you know.
Give out that information. And do you have something posted on Facebook?
Actually, it's on my main page. And if you look at the picture on my page, you'll see the flyer.
Okay.
That's my main picture on the page. That's the flyer talking about the women's conference.
Okay. We want to act accordingly. If you guys are connected with her over on Facebook, I know I'm going to go over there and I'm going to share it. I'm going to put it out there on my wall. And if anybody, excuse me, if you're not connected with her already, you can get it off of my wall and share it. I want us to get it on out there and help get this off the ground. I'm telling you, give the information so that we can act accordingly and help you get this thing out.
Anybody
and
who
also,
wants to send anybody the flyer in your Facebook inbox, I can send you the flyer or I can make an announcement.
Okay.
On, you know how they do those things on there where they let you know when somebody says something. I can do that, and you can share that too. It's June the 6th and the 7th at 7 o'clock here in Philadelphia, June the 6th and the 7th.
Okay.
Thursday is going to be an evangelist from Las Vegas, and her name is Patricia Ransom. And then on Friday, it'll be Stacy Lattisaw. And I think I shared that with you before. She used to sing R&B.
Yeah.
But she's an evangelist now, so she'll be here on that Friday.
Okay. 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 That's all. Thank you, Jesus. June 6th and 7th in Philadelphia. My son is in Philadelphia.
Is he?
As a matter of fact, I'm supposed to be coming up there to visit him soon. I'm going to give you guys a call when I'm headed up that way. And hopefully I'll get a chance to see you guys while I'm there. But he's in Philadelphia. He's in Philadelphia. And as a matter of fact, I got to come up that way anyway, going to New Jersey. Revival coming up in New Jersey for Prophet Williams. And we're gonna be coming up that way. So either way it goes, some kind of how we'll get a chance to meet with one another, and my God for Zion, we're going to do everything that we can to help you promote this conference. It is very, very imperative, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart. We want to help one another move forward. You guys got this thing going on. We want to try to get it out there on LinkedIn and everywhere else that we're connected. Get the word out, because there's a lot of people up that way. I got cousins up in New Jersey. I'm sure that they would love to come down. They wouldn't mind coming down. We'll get that information into their hands as well.
It's free.
Oh, it's amen.
It's totally free. I did have a registration fee, but I took that off. So it's free. It's going to be a free will offering.
Okay. Well, everybody on the line, we're going to do our part and help out. Now, Evangelist Bradford, he's not on the Internet right now. He's still not supposed to do anything that could stir him up or whatever the case may be. Even though the doctor has released him, you know, he's still trying to take it easy, get his strength back and everything. And so he's the only one that might not be able to do anything on the Internet just yet. But I'm sure that he may be able to send some information out to folks through the phone or whatever the case may be, helping the folks know what's going on. We just want to sincerely help one another. And we want to encourage one another. And you know it's nobody but God, Sister Scott, that placed that in my spirit concerning you and your husband and writing. And that's nobody but God. And then, you know, I'm preaching to others on the line too, because there are several people who got books in them, plays in them. They got all kinds of stuff. We, you know, as much encouraging that we do each and every day on our blog talk, radio broadcast, different, and Spreaker and so forth, there's no reason why we can't put a lot of the things that we say on CD or on DVD.
I was supposed to do that too. And anyway, just didn't do it.
Well,
I don't even have an excuse. I just didn't do it.
Well, if it's all right, and I'm sure it is, we just going to stay on top of each other and encourage one another.
Amen.
To do what God has called us to do. Because I'm telling you, this is one of the things that God told me. He said, every day that I don't perform his will is another day I have missed reaching someone he determined for me to reach.
Wow.
There are people he has ordained, literally designated for you to minister to, that no one else can touch, no one else can reach but you. Now, I'm not trying to put a fire on nobody, and yes, I am trying to put a fire on you, because I want you the same way God dealt with me. I'm just going to put it out there with you. Every day, we don't do what God called us to do. It's another day we fail to reach that soul that he designated for us to reach. Mm. This is the reason why, no matter how tired I am, No matter, I don't care what my mood is, I don't care how I feel in my body, or whatever the case may be, I'm going to get up and I'm going to put that word out there, because somebody needs to hear it.
Thank you.
Somebody needs to hear it. And I have found, as I shared the testimony with you before, that when I press through the mess, I always get blessed.
That's right.
I press through the mess, I always get blessed. Amen. Amen.
Amen. So,
yes, sir.
I just got one thing to interject, if I could, just for a second. You know, all of us that are here have audio accounts, like on Blog Talk, Spreaker, and other ones that we do. The Lord just spoke to my heart when you were ministering about all that. If we could make like a 30-second infomercial and everybody be playing this, like for a break, or you know, like midway through, if you're doing an hour broadcast, you just do a 30-second, you know, like about the clothing or the book or you got a short. You're in there and you're out. You know what I'm saying? But you play it. It's like if you got a 2-hour broadcast you're doing, you can play it 3 or 4 different times, or 3 or 4 different ones. Or
come on.
Break. Yep.
Wow.
We'll run our own ads.
Wow. You know what? You may mention about that before, Evangelist. You may mention about that before. And, you know, it's just a God's honest truth. It's just a God. And you know what? There's no reason why we can't do it. If anyone, like for instance, Evangelist Scott, do you know how to create an infomercial?
I'm sorry. You didn't ask me.
Sometimes I have an intro that comes on my when I come on, but it's noise in the background, so I haven't perfected that yet. And I'm still looking. I'm looking for somebody to help me. I'm doing the event right now.
Okay.
So you'll see it. I'm putting the event up for the women's conference right now, so you guys can see it. And you can just go on that page and share it if you want to.
Okay, I'm going to do that. Now, the reason, I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to interrupt, but the reason why I said that is because Minister Robin Lynn could create an infomercial for anybody who needs it. She could do that for you, and she could send me a copy. I could put it up on my Blog Talk, put it up on Spreaker, put it up all over the place, and so that people would know what's going on. And that's a very, very good idea, Evangelist Bradford. That's a very good idea. Very good idea.
Excellent.
I'm so glad you.
Excellent.
Yes, indeed.
Well,
yes,
I have
indeed.
My hand raised because I sure need it. That and a couple of other things, but
amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I will get in touch with you.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's a couple of things that I need to get done quickly.
Okay. Same thing for Apostle Reed. We could do the same thing. We could do one for Prophet Williams.
Everybody.
And put it out there. Put it out there, because I'm telling you. And see, y'all know I love my spiritual father. I love him. He is truly an awesome blessing. And I tell you, I tell you what, the things that he's written in that book, I mean, he exposes what he's been through. He is, and you know, he took a big hit. You know, people were jumping on him, telling him you shouldn't share that, you shouldn't say that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and people, let me tell you something. I'm so thankful to God that I'm delivered from man and his Adamic nature. I don't know what
Thank
to do with
Lord.
Myself. Because I'm tired of people sitting up trying to dictate what you should and what you shouldn't do. And actually, it's not the people, it's the devil himself. The reason why he's saying what he's saying is because he knows if you put that in there, if you say that, somebody going to get healed. Somebody's going to get delivered. Somebody's going to get set free. He knows that.
Come on now.
So he's going to do everything he can to discourage you from sharing. But I'm telling you, put it out there. I'm telling you, I learned this. Make your message, honey. Let me tell you something. Be a blessing to others, amen. Your testimony, the Bible tells us in the book of Revelation, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Other people are going through what you've been through.
Yeah.
And need to know that there is a way out. Need to know that there's life. After this, there is a blessing at the end of this thing.
I'm telling you,
even the Bible tells us that we're compassed with a great cloud of witnesses, meaning that there's other people that have been through what we're going through. And through their lesson, through their testimony, through God's testimony of them, we overcome. So we need to do the same for others. And I'm just encouraged. I really am. I'm encouraged by everything that's being said and done here tonight. Before we pray this thing out, because I want to get some input from everybody. But Teresa, do you know how to get in touch with Minister Robin Lynn?
Yes, we're Facebook.
Okay. Because I want to make sure that you guys so she can help you. Get your infomercial together. I want a copy of it so I can play it on Blog Talk and on our other networks, Spreaker and other places, so that we can really, really advertise this thing, market it, get it on out there, get the word on out there, okay? And then, you know, call some people up in that area. If you guys know anybody in the Pennsylvania area, you know, Ohio, New Jersey, up in that area, you can call them and let them know what's taking place so that, amen, they can come down, amen, and partake in what's taking place. It's a solemn assembly, and I believe with all of my heart that God is going to move by
amen.
His Spirit. You understand what I'm saying? We need to do that for each other. We need to believe for one another. And I mean really believe for one another, y'all. I mean that now from the bottom of my heart. I don't care what the enemy say. I don't care what he do. I don't care what the past dictate or whatever the case may be. We need to believe for one another. And I'm telling you, it is imperative that we do so. It's imperative that we do so. It proves your relationship with God. It
yeah.
proves it. We could talk all day long, but honey, actions speak way louder than words. That's the God's honest truth. So I'm going to shut my mouth and give everybody else an opportunity. If there's any ideas that anybody wants to share or whatever the case may be, again, Evangelist Bradford, that's a powerful idea. We're going to get that thing going.
Amen.
Anybody else got anything they want to share?
I do.
Okay.
Oh, go ahead. I heard somebody. Go ahead.
I was wondering, do you still send out your ministry newsletters?
Say that again?
Do you still send out your ministry newsletters?
Oh, you know what? I need to get that back up and running. For those of you who don't know, that's my wife, Tamiko Timberlake, speaking now. Amen.
God bless you.
Same to you.
Amen. We are going to pick that back up. We had a newsletter that I would send out every week, and we would keep people apprised as to what the ministry was doing, who was going to be speaking on the broadcast, where we were going to be preaching at, different things of this nature, and I let it go, but we need to pick it back up. We did have a newsletter that we would send out every week, and we're going to pick that back up. there's a lot of things that we need to do, and we're going to get it done. But that's a good question. I'm glad you asked that. Yeah, we're going to get that back.
Man.
Is there Minister Robin Lynn?
Oh, first I want to give a shout-out to my brother Mike. You've been my brother for a number of years now, and I love you. I love you so much. And Dr. Green Reed, my heart is just full of you.
And Apostle, God bless you.
Apostle, you my pastor.
That's true. God bless you.
And the bishops, the both of you, y'all are just my brother and my sister. Just y'all, just that's all I could say.
Thank
I got
you.
some solutions and a couple of things for us to do.
Mm-hmm.
So when we go on there posting on Facebook and wherever,
yes.
Also go down and take the time to leave a comment and
yes.
Hit that like button. And then
yes.
If someone is promoting a page, make sure you go to the page and go to the top of that page and
Amen.
Hit the like button as well. And that's what's called generating buzz.
Okay.
And when you make a comment, other people will see, it'll catch their eye. And
mm-hmm.
they'll leave comments in too, so it generates buzz. I'm going to set up an online office through
mm-hmm.
Google from Powerhouse Ministries International, and I'll get everybody that's online hooked
mm-hmm.
up with that. And then we'll use that. We'll be able to use that for a whiteboard, information dissemination, and all that will be a central place, okay? And then I'm also, it doesn't take much to do the promos or anything else. You need the infomercials or like that, and we can do it over the telephone.
Amen.
And we can do it over the telephone and have the music going and everything. And
yeah.
And we can usually get it in one or two takes, and so it's just a matter of knowing what you want to say. And another shout out to my brother Mike, because I learned a lot of this stuff from things that you shared with me. So thank you.
Hey, dog.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord. God bring it forth. Mm-hmm.
If I don't have that office, the cloud office hooked up for us tonight, I'll have it tomorrow, and then I'll put all our information in there and numbers and stuff, and then I'll be calling you so we can do those promos. So answer my call.
Hey, Sister Scott, it would be good if you would write yourself out a little script.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And that way, when you guys go to do the commercial, you already know what you want to say. It's right there. Boom. It just makes it easier. That's all.
I have my script.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a painless process. My God's Gathering in Pakistan, that's the ministry that's under the umbrella. They just started. About a month ago, over 100 other homes were burned, and
wow.
It left thousands of them homeless. And then last Friday, they were threatening them with fires and violence again, and there was a lot of brutality, and the women were brutalized and things like that. So I've got their information up on posting, and then if you can go to the website, there's a donate button, and it would just be a great help. And then also, even if you can't make a donation, even more than that, if you would make comments, I made a slideshow and of the fires and stuff. One thing I'm trying to do is when these incidents happen, and it's persecution against the Christians.
Mm-hmm.
And when these things happen, it doesn't get out on the news.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you see those, when you see my information out there on Pakistan, if you guys could like it, post it, visit the sites, and just help me keep activity there, and that will help me get the news out. Because when they've got more people outside of the country being aware, then it doesn't make it like easier. But it makes it easier when the world is standing with them, is all I can say. So And that's all I have.
Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, so we're gonna work to no end to get the word out about the conference, about the Song of Solomon Affordable Boutique, and everything else that's going on Prophet Williams' book. And also remember our brother Evangelist Bradford. Amen. If you guys are able, amen, to support or send gifts of support to him, please do so. His PayPal account is revivalfire@cableone.net. revivalfire@cableone.net. Amen. We're going to send you some more support. I know how it is. We know the times are hard today, but I'm going to tell you something. The Lord showed me that my attitude, my expectation, my expectation demands a manifestation.
Amen.
I don't allow no critical spirit to interfere with nothing. I believe. I'm going to tell you, I can't express this enough. Every time I get something in my mind, and it's established, I thank God and I praise him and I'm in expectation. I always receive it. I'm sitting up here. I was just talking with the Lord today. I said, God, I don't see my new vehicle in the driveway, but I know it's there. I took the, you know, God spoke to me because I used to say, I don't see my new SUV. I said, but I know it's there. And God spoke to me. He said, take the box. Get me out of the box. He said, you don't know what I want to bless you with. You don't know what I want to give you. I said, well, I thank you for the new vehicle. I know you don't bless me with what, but I thank you for the new miracle. Whatever it is, God, I thank you. I bless your holy name. So, there's some things, I'm telling you, boy, when God see that faith bubbling over inside you, faith is knowing. I'm sorry, I come to understand. Faith is knowing. It's not believing as in hoping. But it's an expectation. I'm looking for it. You follow what I'm saying? I can't be discouraged because I know it's coming. You follow what I'm saying? That's true faith. Faith doesn't get trampled on. It doesn't fade. It doesn't wane. It stands its ground because it knows God promised. He promised, and it's going to come. It's going to happen. I don't care how long I've been waiting. I don't care how long this thing's been going on. And people sit back and say, you know, you always got somebody who's going to throw it in your teeth. Amen. You've been saying that for quite some time. So has the Father from the very beginning. Doesn't mean the world ain't coming to an end. You hear what I'm saying? Doesn't mean that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ ain't on his way back here.
My point is that,
amen, I cannot be defeated in the area of my faith because I know that God, who promised it, is going to bring it to pass. He's going to bring it to pass. He's going to make this thing happen. It's already done. I receive it. I'm telling you, I'm walking in it even now. You hear what I'm saying? Even now. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I'm talking to somebody's soul, and they're going to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Be healed. Be healed in the name of Christ. In the name of Christ. All the bad hurts, all the disappointment, all the letdown, glory be to God, be healed in the name of the Lord. God ain't never failed. He ain't never failed, and he never will. He never will. He never will. Glory to God. There is no failure in our God. There is no failure in our God. Hallelujah. 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 There is no failure. There is no failure. There is no failure.
Hallelujah.
There is no failure. There is no failure. There is no failure. There's a breakthrough. There's a breakthrough. I'm sorry. There's a breakthrough. Glory be to God. There's a break. Oh, my God. There's a breakthrough. There's a breakthrough. It's done.
Hallelujah.
It's done. It's done. Glory to God. Doom and gloom, you don't live here no more. Unbelief and doubt, you don't live here no more. Hopelessness and despair, you don't live here no more.
Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah.
We are more than conquerors.
Hallelujah.
Through him. Hey! Hey! Glory! Hallelujah!
Can I interject with something?
Come on. Come on.
It's coming.
Bless the Lord. It won't play. Oh, here we go.
I always win. I've got victory. Can't no devil in hell stop me. I've got victory. I always win. Say it
Holy name.
Amen.
I felt like I was on blog out there for a minute.
I word.
Listen, yes, sir.
Yeah, I just want everybody let everybody know I'm just going through a ministry rearrangement at this present time. Apostle knows about it, and so just be praying for me.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen, Mike. Miss you. Love you, too.
I love you too.
Listen, I need to make this announcement too before I forget. You guys can mark your calendars. Prophet Williams gave me leeway to have our ordination service at his church in Cleveland, Ohio, in November.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're going to have a consecration and ordination service in Cleveland in the month of November. Now, we're looking at the weekend of the 15th, 16th, and the 17th, or the 22nd, 23rd, and 24th. I got to get in touch with the sister, and so she can solidify one of these weekends for me. But it is set. He said that anything that we need, he'd be more than happy, amen, to accommodate us. We're going to utilize his facility. We have quite a few people that we're going to consecrate and ordain. Amen. Glory be to God. And it is going to be, I believe, a very powerful service. He, of course, will be there. His ministry is going to be there to support us. Amen. To help us. Amen. And I'm just excited. I'm very excited. Some of you guys, amen, those of you, and I'm praying that all of you, amen, that are a part of Powerhouse will be able to be there. You'll get a chance to meet my family, amen, glory be to God, my aunts, and all kinds of folks, amen. We're going to eat, we're going to, we're just going to pull out the red carpet. We're going to have an awesome, awesome time, amen.
Amen.
Get yourselves prepared.
Hallelujah.
Get yourselves prepared, and amen. It's a done deal. It's a done deal.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God. So, believe it or not, I'll be ordaining him too, along with
amen.
The rest of you. Amen. Glory be to God. It is going to be an awesome, awesome occasion. Get your shower shoes on, because I'm telling you, those folks like to shower.
I'm going to break a few. Don't say nothing. Don't get in my way. I'm going to break a few.
Come on.
Oh, she said she's going to break a few. My God. Bless your heart. Bless your heart. Lord have mercy. I'll tell you, it's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be
Jesus,
awesome.
Jesus, hallelujah.
Evangelist Bradford, amen, glory to God.
Thank you, Lord.
We're going to make sure that everything goes smoothly. We're going to have time, you hear me? My family's going to be there. Everybody's going to be there. So, amen, glory be to God. We're going to have folks from New Jersey down. Amen, glory be to God. We're going to have folks, oh, Lord have mercy, they're coming from everywhere. So we're just going to have a good time. You hear me? We're going to have a good time. So y'all mark that down. After I talk with her, I'll be calling you, I would like to do this every week, come together every week, if that's all right with everybody. If you're able to, I'd like to keep the same time, same day. We'll just come back together again next week, and if I don't contact you before then, I'll have the actual date set, and then you can mark it on your calendars, and prepare yourselves. Now, there ain't no special clothing line you got to get. None of that. I would that everyone would wear white, if that's at all possible. That's all I ask. If you don't have a white robe or whatever the case may be, wear a white dress or two-piece or whatever. Just as long as it's white. And there's a reason for that. Amen. It's about the white linen representing the righteousness of the saints. Mm-hmm. Amen. That's what it's all about.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be a solemn assembly. So keep that in mind. Amen. Glory be to God. And we're going to go on from there, all right? Are there any questions, comments? Anybody else have anything they want to add? All right. All right. thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Minister Robin Lynn, would you pray us out, please?
Father,
and I'm
going to
make sure. Oh, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I want to make sure. After this is over, I'm going to make sure everybody gets a copy of this meeting. Okay, so I'm going to email it to you. All right. I'm sorry. That's all I wanted to say.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Father God, we are so grateful and very humble before you, Father God, for this opportunity. And we thank you for bringing us together on one accord, Father God, because we understand that that is the way. And we ask that you continue to bless us, Father God, with your love, Father God, that we continue to walk in love, Father God, because love never fails. Continue to lead, guide, direct, and touch us. Stay ever before us, Lord. And help us to always stay and remain with you, Father God. You said that if we abide in you, then you will abide in us.
Yes.
And that is my prayer. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we apart from one another. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
All right. Next week, Sunday, we'll come back together, and we will appoint everyone their position in the ministry. Of course, I've told you about Minister Robin Lynn being national leader. Apostle Reed is the Minister of Education in our ministry. We're going to develop Sunday school books, and we're going to develop Bible study books.
Amen.
Now, we're going to do this. We're going to do this.
Amen. Amen.
It's our purpose.
Amen.
I'm going to fail God in this. Amen. Glory to God.
Right. Amen.
One is anointed, amen, to do a particular thing. If we wanted to appoint everyone, amen, glory be to God, everybody got something to do. So, amen. For everybody, amen, that is on the line, and there's a lot more on this line that haven't said anything, but it's okay. It's okay. We're going to catch you guys next week if the Lord says the same. All right? And Evangelist Scott, I'm giving it a go over on Facebook now and take care of that, okay?
All right.
Be ever. And tell Bishop I said hello, okay?
I sure will. Joe. He might have fell asleep, but I know he was on the line earlier.
Amen. Just give him my love, okay?
I sure will.
We'll talk next week. All right. God bless you, each and every last one of you.
Your conference recording.